Yo, Trey P. I need all the ladies to report to the front of the club right now. It's about to go down.
The hitmaker's back.
Yeah.
If you came to party, then just throw your hands up in the sky. Little finger in the air if you smoking that ooh la la. We gon' party, we gon' push it. Money, dreams, girls, got my
let's go.
Yeah, we blazing.
Yo, woke up in the club. They roll like the red carpet for me and my nigga, cause I got a buzz. I've been waiting on the ball, but to go harder. Now my line up looking like a super shack. Do you know who we are, girl, with the caviar? So
listen, girl, I'm a song. You gonna get it right now? I was gonna let you get on stage. It's up on you, though. So, hey, she said she want one more person to come with her, though. Who else from Dallas? Anybody else from Dallas? Hold on, I'm gonna sit. You ready? You gonna go? Oh, I got three of them coming now. Y'all make some noise for Dallas, man. Chicago people, y'all ready? Chicago, like, I need three Chicago people too. And y'all step back off of that, because if y'all fall in, you will fall in. Jackson State is not responsible. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You from Dallas too? Alright, well, this is what we're gonna do. Hold on, where y'all from right here? Thundercats. Where y'all from? Hey, stop! Hammer time. Where y'all from? Alright, Chicago, y'all wait, Joe. Alright, so I got all four of y'all from Dallas. Alright, teach us how to dig it real fast. Was somebody coming? Okay, so is anybody from Africa in here? You know, I got some Lion King music. You know, okay, never mind. If you get the refund check, let me hear you make some noise. Yeah. Now let me tell y'all what you don't do. Don't go to CDG and don't go to Men in Fashion trying to buy the same outfits as everybody else. Alright, them snapbacks just ain't that fun to be wearing the same one 13 other people got. Alright, we're gonna get ready to get this show started, man. I need everybody in the building to stand to your feet right now. You need to show these people some JSU love. Everybody in the building to stand to your feet right now. And soon as I say his name. I need you to start clapping for him, showing some love, make him feel welcome, make him feel like he's supposed to be here. All right? Here it is. Hold on. All right, never mind. All right, that was a warm-up. That was the warm-up. It's coming now. Just be prepared. Everybody give it up to Puerto Rican. Not the dancer, but the DJ. All right, are y'all ready? We're gonna do this like PT. Everybody ready? Everybody ready? Position! Coming to the stage! Coming to the stage is Love! Love! Y'all gotta keep clapping! Keep clapping!
What's up? What's up? I got two of those. With the blue city, got my new slow. Cut back, snap back, see my track through the holes. Cold, easy, and hold. Where the hell you been? It's time for real reasons.
Stop here. Let that ride, let that ride.
About to make them tuck the other side of it. They say I'm crazy, but I'm about to go dumb again. They ain't see me cause I pulled up at my other bins. Last week, I was in my other bins. Throw your damn son, come in and get another key. I'm too fresh, look like wealth. I'm about to go up.
What's up? How y'all doing? Y'all doing alright? Alright, appreciate y'all coming out. Yeah, what was the last of the dude and the chick with the jeans on? What was that? What was that? Right there. Yeah, that was terrible. Oh, y'all should have been killed. And the little dude with the shoes on, go ahead and make your peace. You're gay. I don't know if you know that now. Get you a real barber to shape your bar. I'm just playing. I don't want no trouble. You know, you probably on the football team and everything, so I'm just saying. Let's do a room check real quick. I know this is the back to school show and all that right there. Where the freshman? Make some noise. Freshman, where the freshman? Okay, so it's mostly freshmen. Sophomores right here. About to get it in. Freshmen, real, real fast. Newsflash, whatever you came to college to be, whatever dream you have, do not be too attached to that shit. Singers, am I lying? Because when you get to this bitch, your head is filled with dreams, hopes, and aspirations. But when you get in this motherfucker, them class start dropping, them turn papers start hitting your ass, You have to reevaluate what the fuck you want to be in life. You came to this bitch like, nigga, I'm gonna be a doctor. Nigga, that goddamn science start moving your ass, that college biology, you be like, shit, nigga, I'm gonna be a PE teacher. I'm gonna change this shit up, nigga. I'm gonna stay true to the game. And real talk, seniors, let them know, some of y'all ain't gonna make it. I ain't talking about dying, I'm talking about just ain't gonna make it. Some of y'all really ain't even here to learn anyway. Some of y'all just came to pledge, get your colors and goddamn bounce, that's it. And that's okay. Some of y'all just ain't gonna make it because you dumb as hell. You got in here because you looked up and got a decent score on the SAT and you were really high for you when to take it and you passed it like, shit, for real? Some of y'all need to just go ahead and learn the metric system really, really well because that is your future. See, right now you fucked up. Like, what do you mean by the metric system? Ounces, kilos. That's the metric system right there. Invest in the scale because you too will be dope boy fresh. This bitch right here. Freshman, make sure if you got a choice, or if you don't have a choice, go ahead and make your peace and become friends with whoever the fuck your roommate is. Right now. Reason why you need to make friends, because at least you can enjoy these first 2 months, because after these first 2 months, you ain't gonna like each other.
Sure,
I'm just being honest with you. Unless you roommates with somebody you already knew before you got to this bitch, you are not gonna like each other about 2-3 months. Am I lying, seniors? Exactly. And I know y'all like, nah, we gonna be cool, bitch. Our roommates be cool. Okay. Keep believing that. You know what's gonna destroy your friendship first and foremost before anything else? One of y'all gonna eat some food that don't goddamn belong to you. And that's gonna get you fucked up. And you a freshman, so you don't really understand the importance of food just yet, because you've been at home with your parents, and you can eat anytime you fucking want to, and you don't realize that food is a goddamn premium. In college, nigga, an apple is like a cigarette in prison. You fuck around and get killed out this bitch of a Granny Smith. You think I'm playing if you want to? You think I'm playing, freshman? It's funny now. Let you fucking come home one day from class and there's some fucking Pop-Tarts in the goddamn cabinet and then your roommates be like, shit, I'm gonna knock this out. She ain't gonna care. She been thinking about that Pop-Tart all goddamn day. She, nigga, as soon as I get out of goddamn English, I'm going to get that Pop-Tart in the cabinet. Get back to the room, and you like, she like, bitch, what happened to the Pop-Tart was in here? Oh, bitch, girl, I hate that. But you finna die. You like, oh, my Pop-Tart? Like, bitch, yes. See, freshman, y'all, see this shit, I'm trying to help you out. I'm trying to save you conflict in your goddamn life. Thing number two, listen, college is like a little small town. Everybody know everybody. Everybody know everybody's business. So if you did it and one other person know it, you might well assume that everybody knows it. Am I right? So this the trick. Do you. Whatever you is, do you. Because no matter what you do, good or bad, somebody still gonna have some shit to say. So you might as well go and do you, be happy, and enjoy these 4 goddamn years. Like I'm saying, like, see, motherfuckers eat freshmen. I'm trying to help you out. Thing number one, but the easiest way to do you is learn who you are real, real quick. Learn who you are, because there's a lot of motherfuckers in here don't know that. I'm trying to help you out. Like, that's where you find yourself at college. Like me, I did a lot of bad shit in college. Did a lot of good shit, but I had a good goddamn time. Like, I know on campus, man, I was known as the being as one of the hoest niggas on campus. I'm judgment. Yeah, I had a good time. Nigga, I dated some of the most trifling women that ever walked across the campus of the University of Maryland. I ain't even lying. And I mean, one time I was dating a chick. She was 22 and had 5 kids. Hey, 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 don't judge her. Hey. See, when girls, ladies, y'all hear that, you be like, oh, that is horrible. Her life is over. Since the dude, I hear you got 5 kids. I'm like, man, that's a good ass right there. I remember one time we was at her, she had a little apartment, we had an apartment, and we in the room fooling around shit, right? And you know, you got 5 kids, somebody always woke. You know what I'm saying? So we in the room fooling around, I'm like, hey, chill out. The kids keep running past the door, they don't see her. Like, hold on, I'm gonna take care of this. I said, what you gonna do? She said, I'm gonna go in the living room, put this Door to Explore DVD on. They gonna be straight. like, what the fuck? So she went in there, put the Jordan Explorer DVD on, and she was right. The motherfuckers was hypnotized. They did not move. Came back in the room, closed the door. We was in that bitch setting off. And this is the problem. She turned the TV up loud because she's trying to drown us out. She don't want the kid to hear us. So while we doing it, I can hear the Dora DVD. So me and Stro, I catch myself barking to the Dora DVD. I'm serious, I'm in the room like, it's the map, it's the map, it's the map, it's the motherfucking map. Swipe it on swipe.
Oh my God.
I came, I was like, oh man. She didn't even care. She just jumped up like, we did it. We did it. I was like, I love you. Tell you, I had my little share though. The old freshman, don't be scared to date the upperclassmen. Or go and get somebody who just graduated. They can teach you some shit. If another freshman can't teach you nothing. I'm serious. I was a sophomore. I dated a chick who was 28. People was like, why you dating that old bitch? Listen, because she was a freak. And she was like the LeBron James of freaks. She was magnificent. Like, a lot of y'all ain't really came in touch with yourself right there. Like, seniors, how many of y'all can see yourself be freaks? Learn to choose freak right in the school. See, they looking at you, they judging you, but they don't know no better. They don't know that you probably had the best 4 years of your life, ain't you? Exactly. And listen, if you're not a freak, you are cheating yourself. Now, let me let y'all, let's make sure we know the definitions. There's a difference between being a freak and being a hoe. They're two different things. And that ain't the same thing. Ho and freak, they're two different words right there. Ho mean everybody. Freak mean one person, everything. That's what that means, my friend. There's a difference right there. See, so listen, if you're not a freak, I'm letting you know right now, you're going to be cheating yourself over the next 4 years. Because when you're not a freak, you have to do the boring stuff. You got to do boring, lame stuff like have sex. That's boring. That's beneath me. I don't want to have sex. With me, it goes down. Seniors, you thought you, when you got here, you know, you might have had a little experience. You thought you was a freak. You messed around, you met somebody that was freaky to you. They did some new freaky shit you ain't never did before. And you liked it, but you ain't know how to deal with it. So you sit on the edge of the bed like a rape victim. You on the edge of the bed like, what is you doing to me? And when can we do that again right there? That's like, she was off the meat rack. I remember one time, and she wanted to do this thing. I didn't even know that what this was about. She like, I want to role play. What the hell is that? She like, that's when we dress up like some other people or some characters, and we do it. I'm like, she is running. So she, I'm like, what you want to play? She like, this plays a game called Slave and Slave Master. What the hell is that? She like, this is what you gonna do. She like, I'm dark skin. She was real light skin. She said, I'm gonna go into bed. And I'm gonna call you like I'm the slave master wife, and I'm mad at you. So she went in there, she was like, Silas, get in here. Now that wasn't my name, but it was some good slave shit though, you know what I'm saying? So then I came to the bedroom door with some tour-up shorts, no shirt on, baby oiled up, so it looked like I've been sweating, working in the field all day, looking dead in the eye, like, what you call me for? That ass up. She was like, one time, she was like, I want you to hit it like you just got off the boat from Africa and you don't even speak English yet. Like, shit, you ain't saying nothing. Hey, I had a spill and everything. I was like, bring that pussy to Shaka. I'm in, sir. Listen, this college, don't get hooked up on relationships. Most of it ain't gonna work out. Just gonna be honest. So enjoy the time you got with whoever you kicking it with right now. If it don't work, charge to the game and keep it moving. Don't be on campus fighting and goddamn stupid on somebody who really don't give a fuck about you for real. Don't be in here fighting. And then that's not good. Like, nigga, stop. Everybody on the football team cut. Now she your girl. Come on, stop. I'm serious, you know? Like, one thing I learned in college is I'll probably never get married. Never. Marriage lasts too long. She's like, forever. Forever, ever? Exactly. Never. And I have y'all in here, like, clap who mom and dad is still young. 10% of y'all. Rest of y'all like me. Niggas ain't been together since you were like 3. Keeping it real. Just keeping it real. Yeah, I don't. Wait, my thing with marriage is ain't no good example. Don't nobody shit work out. But I live in Atlanta. I remember when Usher got ready to get married, our city was on fire. Everybody's like, Usher get ready to get married. Usher get ready to get married. I was like, that shit ain't gonna work. He's like, why you say that? He just hate. He just being negative. I was like, listen, shit's not gonna work. I see the signs. He's like, whatever. 3 years later, released a little song, Paper. I'm like, Paper. I was like, I told y'all it wasn't gonna work. And they're like, how you know? I was like, because ain't nobody tell Usher to marry the bitch look like Terrell Owens. That's how I feel. Whatever, he the only one. I'm still walking around Atlanta trying to figure out the hell T.I. was thinking about. Ooh, my ass. How you the king of the South, but you married a bitch Peggy? For real? Come on, y'all know Tiny look like Miss Piggy. Stop playing. Man, is it just me, or when she talk on that show, it look like one half of her mouth don't be moving? Like, this bitch had a stroke or something. I watched one episode, she's like, I'm just ready for Tip to come home. Bitch, you need to make an appointment with your primary care physician. She's fucked up. Tiny is not cute. She is a waste of light skin. Really, she is. She should flip her face over because it done on that side right there. And she got the tattoos and shit. She should have got a tattoo of another bitch face on top of her face. Oh, Tiny look like a bucket of fuck that shit. She is, bro. Unattractive. She is horrible looking. Jeez. She is worthless. It is, man. There ain't no great shit. That is the worst, man. I just think, and before I say, listen, if I don't say shit else, I got to make sure I say this. Hey, don't believe everything y'all read on Facebook. Facebook is the worst. Facebook is the devil. It has destroyed many relationships, households, jobs, and everything. And you people that update your status every 10 minutes, kill yourself. I hate you. They be updating with stuff that nobody even want to know. Going to the cabin. I was on Facebook one day, like, ladies, y'all the worst. I'm on Facebook, this chick was killing this dude. She's like, if you ever date Mike, he ain't shit. I hate him, he cheated on me. And don't mess around with it. This thing's small, and he be coming in like 2 minutes. And I fucking hate you, he owed me money. I was like, for real? For real? Listen, ladies, that serves no purpose. Get on Facebook or Twitter going ham. Serves no purpose. Because no matter what you say on Facebook or him about him and his little buddy, at the end of the day, he still hit you. that don't take that away. You still are on the Ben Smash list, all right? That's been one thing. Number two, fellas, don't be on campus all mad because you got hammed on Facebook or whatever right there. Listen, if you're in a relationship and it ends bad, that's the first thing they gonna do, attack your little buddy. That's the first thing they do. And listen, you don't feel no pressure about your little buddy. I don't feel no pressure. I don't know why dudes aspire to have the biggest little buddy anyway. For what? For what? That serves no purpose. The vaginal canal is only 4 inches long, so if you like 10 inches, what? That is a waste. I'm going to chop that off and get into somebody who ain't got it right now. That's just a waste right there. The biggest. I don't want the biggest. Got a nice mid-sized, hard-working, blue-collar little man. He show up to work every day. He part of the union. He understand a team effort. That means part of the team. That means if he can't get a job done, he clock in. This is what I'm talking about. See, freshmen don't know nothing about that yet, man. What did you talk about? He clock in. He be talking to you? Yeah. He be talking to you. Mississippi, or y'all from where? Y'all heard the DJ asking. I'm from Atlanta. Where Atlanta? Thanks, Mississippi, where y'all at? Make some noise. Mississippi. That's from Tulsa. Louisiana, make some noise. Yeah, Louisiana. Four of y'all. That's it. Chicago. Damn, don't shoot. Oh, speaking of Chicago and don't shoot, listen, hey. You in college. Ain't no such thing as being a thug and being in college. That don't go together. Ain't you no thug and you in college? What is that about? How you a murderous killer, kicking bitch down the stair dude, and you sitting in tree in class? That don't go together. Yeah, I mean, one time, I was in college, and this dude, we was at this party. We was having a good time. You know, there's always some dudes messed up. This dude, he looked like a thug. He had cornrows, back pants, big chain, that thing. These dudes, they got to argue. I was like, dude, let's go. It's about to go down. I was like, why? It's like, the thug's about to get it. He's like, then, so he's like, I'll tell you what, B, I'm going to go to the car. Be here when I get back. I'm like, yeah, it's time to go. It's about to go down. So I'm outside in the parking lot and I'm looking for him because I want to know which way he went. So I know which way he can go in the opposite direction. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking for his car because I know thugs drive stuff like Cadillacs, automobiles, Chevy Caprices, and Box Chevy, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? And so I see him walk across the parking lot and say, oh, let me see what car he going to so I can be far away. He gets his car, this nigga get in the pink Ford Focus. With Mary Kay on the back one of them. I would have slapped the hell out of him. I said, go apologize. That nigga say, don't fight. That's it. I just, I don't get that right there. And just like, and I learned from First 48, ain't no thugs anyway. I ain't never watched an episode of First 48, but dude in the interrogation room went crying like a little bitch in the first place. He wasn't. Like, then that chick, like, what's her name? Caroline Mason from Memphis? Woo! She be breaking dudes down like compound fractions. Memphis in the house, where y'all at, Memphis? Woo! Yeah, y'all get away. Memphis so ghetto, it's a goddamn shame. How did y'all even graduate high school? Whatever, nigga. I went to Memphis, they had 10,000 students and 400 books. What that mean? Somebody ain't learning some shit. Oh, so I'm lying? Yeah, all right, whatever. You from Memphis too? Yeah, okay. So they wearing those type of shirts in Memphis right there? Okay. Speak to herself. Speak to herself. And that ain't gotta be the ugliest shirt on earth. You like that shirt? Somebody said they like it? Yeah. You ain't even seen this shirt. Tell me you like it. Borderline hoe. It's like anything. But I like it from over here. You can't even see it, though, man. Calm down. She mad at me. Thank you. Hey, listen. I don't know. Anybody here want to do something besides go to college? You just here because your parents make you go to school? Keep it real. Yeah, ain't nothing wrong with that. You ain't the only one. Like, anybody here want to be in the entertainment industry? For real? And just came to college to have something to fall back on? Make some noise. Keep it real. No knock on you. It ain't a bad little industry being, but like you have to decide what you want to do. Cause first, I didn't want to be no comedian. When I started out, when I was young, you know what I want to be? I want to be a singer. That's my shit. I want to be an R&B singer. Cause I was like, nigga, that is the shit. R&B singers look so happy. Their videos cool as hell. Huh? See, that's what stopped his career. I can't sing. That was it right there. But I'm working on a record deal right now, working with a couple of producers, trying to get back on, because I've learned that being able to sing is not a requirement for a record deal anymore. And hey, I know I ain't the only person that had a favorite song or a favorite artist, then you see them sing live in an award show, you be cussing at the TV. Like, damn, fucking Trey Songz, what are you doing? Whatever. He was at the BET Awards, sounded horrible. And I got a friend, one of my real producers, I asked him, I said, I'm like, how so many people get record deals who can't sing? And he broke it down. He's like, because record companies don't care if you can sing. All record companies care is that you fit their formula. I'm like, the hell is the formula? He's like, this is the formula. He broke it down to me. So people that want to get in the industry, this is the formula right here. To be a successful R&B singer, first, you need a hot track. Once you get a hot track, you need a catchy hook. Words in the songs don't matter no more. You sing about whatever you want to, hot pockets, Doritos, whatever. Once you get the hot track and the catchy hook, Then you need a video. The video is what the record companies use to create the image that they want to sell to you. Successful R&B videos must contain four basic elements. A slow motion scene, a sexy walk, you have to be able to dance or look like you can dance, and a light-skinned girl. No disrespect to the dark-skinned sisters, but typically the lead in R&B videos is a slim light-skinned chick, am I right? So I heard the formula, and that's why I hooked up with my producer. I was like, dude, we can do this shit, because I can follow that thing. Like, I said, DJ, do me a favor, give me some, hold on, before you play, though, there's gotta be a dark-skinned dude. Give me some shit by a dark-skinned dude. Give me your R&B song. Yeah, give me your R&B song. Okay, turn it up, turn it up. Tyrese, come on, you feel like you should be doing this shit right here. You gonna feel sexy as hell. Listen, I'ma show y'all, we almost got a record deal. I'ma show y'all how, and I can't sing worth a fuck. I can't, you put a note in my hand, I can hold that bitch. Listen. But I know how to follow instructions. I'ma show you, this. We ready for the first, we gonna make the first video, right? I'm gonna show you I'm ready for this goddamn record deal. I can follow instructions, you just gotta have a slow motion scene, sexy walk, either dance or look like you can dance, and the light skin girl, right? I am ready for a goddamn record deal. I'm signing a goddamn Def Jam next year. I'm going here. When I get to the wall, start the Tyrese in front of the very beginning one more time. Turn it up loud.
When you start speaking Spanish,
fanboy. That's my shit right there. That's on Montana right there, man. You want to say that dope? Y'all right? Y'all give it for Loud Love one more time. Loud Love. I know I'm in Jackson right now. What people from the hood at? If you're from the hood, make sure you know. I got a song I can tell if you're from the hood. Fellas, look at the girl next to you. If she know all the words of this song right here, play it right here. Play this song. Freshman in the house, makes another freshman. Yes! Well, y'all start first day of school tomorrow, right? Monday, right? First day of school? Freshman, be careful. All the sophomores and juniors, y'all can tell freshman first day, right? Y'all can tell them they got their best shit on first day of class, huh? Dudes be juniors on y'all looking at the girl, talking, that's a freshman right there. How you know, nigga, she got on a prom dress. I seen a girl one day first day of school, she had a whole wedding dress on with a veil and said, what's up? Going to math. You're doing too much. Oh my goodness. Glad to be here. Shout out to everybody who must in here. I know somebody must in this bitch. Raise your hand if you think somebody who must in this point of my. I'm just kidding. Don't do that. I'm just kidding. They're like right here. They smell like earring bats. Only reason I say that because it's hard when it's hot outside, because it's hard being the big dude, because this is not fat people weather at all. And every time somebody in the room stinking, y'all think it's me. I see y'all in the club, girl. It's somebody that must in hell. I don't know who it is, but that fat boy is sweating. Like, bitch, I got big pot everywhere. I'll punch in your goddamn ear. You don't talk to me like this. I'm an American, damn it. Because I promise I've been a nice looking big dude. I go shopping. I take 3-4 showers a day. Y'all always mess with me. I don't like that. And I know I had to lose weight too. I gotta lose weight because white people come to me giving me weight loss advice I've never met before, and they want to be like, why don't you just walk? Jesus. Why don't you drink water and walk? Damn it, man. Don't you want to live? It's like, bitch, I walked here. Kiss my ass. And like, if you ain't never been big before, you don't know what big people go through. Like, if you never been fat before, you don't know what we go through. Like, we want to walk. We want to exercise, which I don't know what we go through. Like, did you know if you walk a lot and your thighs touch, that the skin might rub the fuck off? Did you know this shit? Skinny, judgmental people, kiss my ass. Feel like the devil is molesting you in this area right here? That is not a happy time, people. That should have stopped you in your tracks. You be walking in the mall like, I think they move from God, Jesus. Why have you forsaken me, Lord? You put your legs back together and see if that's what you thought it was. Let me just see right here. Skin, no skin at all. That shape is the worst, fellas. Y'all call the shape. If you play football in high school, you know what I'm talking about, fellas. If that shit rub raw between your legs, that is not a happy time. I remember one time, my shit burned so bad. I was in high school. Luckily, I was in high school. I had some shorts, so it burned so bad. I just busted in the classroom and grabbed the erase off the chalk. But I was like, ah! I was like, thank you, Jesus, for the powder relief. I looked up, it was a retarded class. They were like, do it again! I gotta do this shit every day in fifth period. What kind of shit is this? Some of y'all got mad because I say retarded. I mean, I'm special class. How many of y'all remember the special class in high school? Y'all remember the special class? Y'all had the special class. Y'all remember the whole hallway smelled like goddamn popcorn? Was any of y'all the ones in high school, if you got a hall pass, you would never go straight back to class? Was anybody like that? Yeah, you just frolic the halls a little bit, have a good time. You ever catch yourself looking in the window of the special class? You ever look in there and realize how nice it is? You ain't even know it's a surprise, right? You look in there, they got a TV, a bed, a stove, a waitress. You're like, oh, I want this class. That's when a dude with a full beard and a helmet pop up. Come on in. You're like, oh, shit. This dude is 27 in the ninth grade. He pop back up. I'm 24. You're like, how did you hear my inner thoughts? He's like, Silky from True Blood. And I know it's a lot of freshmen here, y'all don't know about the college experience yet, but all y'all can relate to one thing. I know everybody here went to high school, everybody does the same thing, I don't care how cute you try to act. Everybody here used to take the after school doo-doo when you come home from school every day, remember that shit? I mean, y'all remember after school doo-doo, make some noise, you remember taking the after school boo-boo, make some noise. Fellas, put the fist up, fellas, put the goddamn fist up, you remember after school boo-boo. Look at all the ladies looking at me like, I don't boo-boo, I don't do-do. A magical fairy comes and takes my poo away and turns it into potpourri. That's what happens. Whatever, ladies, y'all poop. It's like once a month, though, like. Y'all see, when y'all think of doing when a girl doodle, it's like a big deal. Y'all see y'all mama text message, I pooped today, LOL. Got like marking on my calendar with the frog sticker. Now, school boo was the worst, because in high school, the last place we ate all the wrong combination of food in the same meal, right? But last time you had pizza, corn, and chocolate milk, right? High school, right? It's like a Taliban bomb check sheet, right? Pizza, corn, chocolate milk, anal explosion. You wash it all down with that old ass cup of fruit cocktail. Y'all remember that old ass cup of fruit cocktail they gave you? With the dead cherry in that bitch, the cherry like it just gave up. Even now. You eat that shit, you drink the juice tastes like Patron. You're like, how old is this? Jeez, I hate you guys a lot. That's what make all that food turn into a category 5 tornado in your stomach, that goddamn fruit cocktail juice. You be on the bus trying to get home, you clench your ass the whole ride home. Ah! Hurry up! Come on! You get off the bus, you got a decision to make now when you're off the bus. You got a long walk to from the driveway to the door. Normally you got a routine when you get off the school bus, right? You check the mail, go in the house. You try to check the mail today, the doodle will interrupt your thoughts. Doodle like, you better get your ass down the driveway. I'm gonna embarrass you out here, it's gonna be bad for you. You ever had a doodle so bad you barely make it to the toilet? You don't even get to take your book bag off, you just barely make it. Oh! Oh! I almost didn't make it, Jesus! Thank you, Father, thank you. I'm gonna bring my phone charger, ah! Bring my phone charging, Mom. You ever do so long, you do all your homework in the bathroom, remember that shit? You get out of the toilet, you got a ring around your booty, like, God damn it, it hurt. I don't like it.
I don't like it.
You can't do it in school, your reputation will be ruined, huh? They'll be like, that gonna make him do it in school, right? What grade he do it? He did it in the second grade, but he still did it. Y'all gonna have a lot of club going. Y'all got club, right? I went to club in Jackson. Y'all still got that club Freelance here? Yeah. That bitch was on the chain last time. I came. Freshman, y'all don't know about the club yet. The funniest thing in college when you go to a club, the funniest shit in college when you go to a club, like especially like a college party that's grown by y'all, is the old ass people that try to sneak in the party. That's the funniest shit ever. Y'all don't go to a club party, like 18 and up party, and it's an old ass man in there. He in there all wrong. He got braids and a bald spot. You don't know what be mad at him or the bitch who braided around ground zero with him. He's like, I'm gonna punch one of y'all in the ear, Jesus. He in the club all wrong. He got a brand new FUBU Platinum velour jogging suit on. I'm like, where you get that shit from? A time capsule? He in the club asking for old man drinks. The waitress never heard of. He's talking about, excuse me, Don, let me get a second sample. Yeah. You know, the waitress is 18 years old. She's talking about, what the fuck is that? We got Henderson, Patron, and Bird. And they get mad. Give me something to take this goddamn pill with, bitch. You know, the old nigga gotta take their medicine by 10 o'clock or they'll die, you know? And you know, he taking his medicine. You know, young girls, now y'all take pills and stuff. When I was younger, if you smoked weed or drink, you was bad. Now, everybody got that one friend to take any pill somebody give it and pop it. Yeah, girl, I'm rolling. The waitress see the old man take his medicine, she get excited. He take his prescription medicine, she roll him up to my, oh, let me get one of them pills, mister. Is you rolling? Bitch, I might be. He give one of the pills 20 minutes later, she in the bathroom, doodling like shit. To my girl, I stopped at her. My friend in the mirror told me I should've took that stool, saw in front of that old ass man, bitch. That was not no bean, that shit was spray five. My granddad take them big ass pills. You stupidinfo.org. Gonna be doing it for 2 weeks straight. I'm gonna get your phone charged, bitch. You stupid as hell. Y'all watch that Braxton show? Y'all watch the Braxtons?
Hey!
Yes, Tamar is the most ghetto chick on earth, ain't she?
Yes.
The funny part about the Braxtons, they don't look as good as Tony, am I right, fellas? The rest of them don't look nowhere near as good as Tony. They look like the evolutionary tribe, like before the caveman turned into the monkey. That's Tony right there, the rest of the sisters right there. They say ghetto shit. The funniest part about that show is when you see Tamar's husband, Vince, every time she get the popular shit, he start talking. She start talking, he just go away. He make a retarded face. As soon as he start talking shit, he just go like this. Say, that nigga just went to go to the corral right there. He just left. And think about what the ladies that ladies in the house make sure we are the ladies. Rough thing about how what the ladies that look like big men. Any ladies like big dudes make sure big dudes. Here y'all. She started clapping. Look at that. She's like, oh, that's your time. Nah. You're a little bigger than I like them. Seriously. You're a little bigger than I take them. Big dudes, we didn't. Big dudes are in style right now. Big dudes become in style into Ruben Water. Y'all remember Ruben Water back then? That was the best summer of my life. 2003. What? As soon as he won, I was in the mall with a 205 shirt on trying to stand bow-legged. It's 205, bitch. But Ruben never looks happy. He won $1 million. He make a face like he been eating sweet tarts all day. Who face did he make? Everybody, Ruben study you the next American Idol. What face this nigga made? Just. Y'all want me to do it again? I gotta ask black people. Y'all want me to do it again? The reason I ask is black people, we don't know that. We like some stuff. Every time I do that joke, it's always about four people in the parking lot with their camera phone. Do that shit again, old fat ass boy. I kill your ass out in vehicle. They know what they want. They got that pistol on them. They want like, I kill everybody in the goddamn. Should have room in the situation where he could use that face. Like during book buyback season. Y'all know about book buyback season? What are sophomores and juniors there? Y'all got that? Y'all got book buyback season? Do y'all have that? Do y'all say y'all books back? Freshman, y'all don't know about this. You gonna buy a book in the beginning of the semester, it gonna cost like $9,000. When you go to sell it back, it's gonna be worth $6. It's gonna be the most disappointing feeling in your life. It hurts so bad, they should just have Ruben behind the counter just to make the transaction go smoothly. Just as soon as you walk in, just.
Hey, Jared.
Do that shit tomorrow. Girl, we went to the show, they fat though, just like
this. The sound, boy. Light,
is
it light?
Somebody, do you have a Facebook? Shit. Oh. I just did that. That's right, that's what I'm talking about. Shout out to everybody who smoke weed. Don't clap, just blink. Just blink, and I'm looking. You can come tap me on the shoulder after the show, just be like, what's up? I'm too big to smoke weed. You can't smoke weed when you're fat, because it make you make bad food decisions when you're fat as hell. You know weed, especially that strong shit, that loud, that kush, all that shit. Ooh, that shit make you hungry for ignorant stuff. I remember I was smoking that loud one night. I was at the McDonald's ordering the most ignorant thing I ever ordered in my life. It's 4 in the morning. I'm at McDonald's like, shit, let me get a goddamn. Shit jamming like a motherfucker. Let me get a guy down. Let me get a down sausage, egg, and cheese, McFlurry. All the fat people are like, that sounds delicious. The bacon and eggs and ice cream converge on your tongue for a trifecta of flavor. Amazing! I'm confusing them though. Well, he keep talking like the white folks, y'all. Oh, shit. Y'all got remedial classes here? Y'all got remedial here? Like learning support or whatever? Woo! What do people in the remedial? Make some noise. Make some noise, remedial!
Everybody like, shit, me. Do they give it to you if you do bad on the placement exam? That's how you do it? Don't feel bad if you got to read it, because I don't feel bad either. Do they give y'all your placement exam like this week, or like do you had it a couple weeks ago? A couple days ago, see, you can't take no test. You've been partying all summer. Some of y'all ain't looked at a book since the week before you graduated high school. Hey, you fam, that's how you be me. I do the same thing all summer. Y'all do the same thing all summer. Everybody do the same thing. You get drunk with your friends all summer, right? Was I lying? Everybody get drunk all summer? Everybody get drunk in a random basement? Anybody got that one friend to get drunk quicker than everybody else and get emotional? Don't you hate this bitch? Y'all two drinks in. She says, I'm gonna miss y'all, man. What you saying, dog? We'll see your ass tomorrow, stupid. Just saying, we go to school, I'm gonna miss y'all. Going to the same school, idiot. And remedial class is the worst, because I went to a white school. I went to a HBC first, and then I transferred. I had to take a placement exam. And I went to drink with white people the night before my placement exam. But white people got a special drink. I don't know how many people don't party with white folk. White people got a special drink that black people don't know about. It's called Jägermeister. And y'all know about it? Hell yeah. Yeah. You drink that for the first time, you're like, oh my God, what is this delicious potion? It tastes like NyQuil and popsicles. And my sinuses are so clear. I'm in Georgia. I went to a country western bar. I'm the only black dude in there. I had like 8 Jager bombs in a row. I got so drunk, I forgot that I was fat and black. I just woke up butt naked on a mechanical bull. That bitch couldn't even move. It was like, and one of the bombs was like, get him off of bed. I said, Jesus Christ. I got so drunk, I don't even remember taking my placement exam. I just woke up in the advisor's office. You know when you do bad on placement, then they send you to an advisor to break the news to you that you got remedial, right? And the advisor always talks to you real soft and calm, like a suicide counselor. I mean, first of all, when I was 18, when I used to get drunk, I used to get real belligerent and pro-black. It was the funniest shit ever, like a chubby black panther in the office. She ended up reading the results to me all slow, like the Maury Povich show. She's like, Ronnie Jordan says here, you didn't do so well on the math or English placement exam. You gotta put your remedial English and math. I mean, I'm like, it's cause I'm black, right? He's like, no, it says here because you're an idiot. For your name, you put triangle. I was like, I changed it, bitch. So I had to take remedial English and math. I had to take remedial English and math. And the worst part about remedial, it's the worst feeling in the world, though, because they make you go to your remedial class like the first one or two classes of the day if they can help. So you can get it over with. That's the worst, because everybody know first day of school, you feel excited about being in college. Especially guys, you feel like a sense of accomplishment. We doing something in our life. You wake up early, get your books together, you walk on campus, breathing in real deep, like I'm doing something. I'm like, yes. You walk in that remedial class, your high come right back down. You walk in, it's like an alphabet chart around the room, like blocks in the corner. You walk in there all pissed off. I can't believe they got me that dumb ass class. So you can't believe they got me this stupid ass class. Oh, what's up, buddy? I know you was in there, bitch. Soon you see your homeboy, you cool as hell, y'all sitting next to each other. And that's the worst in the world. You sitting in there, they ain't got no books on the desk. They got coloring books and juice and shit. They got blocks in the corner. You sitting out looking at the textbook, reflecting on your life. You looking out like, how did I end up in a remedial math class? And this is the textbook is a coloring book. And they say it on the cover of the book, 099 Remedial Math, M-A-F-F. That is not how you spell math at all. And remedial English is the worst. Remedial English, you don't even get a book for this class. It's you and 20 adults staring at a cassette player listening to the vowels tape. All y'all been quiet as hell listening to my A-E-I-O-U. Sometimes, why, that shit gonna be on the final. I need to get a pen, I need to write that shit down. You ever catch somebody, you ever be going to class, and you go into your remedial class, and somebody asks you what class you're going to, you just panic? You walk in class, what class you going to, Ronnie? What class I'm going to? Everybody on this campus in my goddamn business. You know what, I'm about to quit anyway. I walk off and sling my book bag. I forget that my book bag wasn't closed all the way. So all my flashcards and timetables charts fell out. This is bullshit. Oh my God. Shout out to dudes, you cannot be, I got an announcement, you cannot be a thug if you got a gay ass ringtone on your phone. feel about to fight everybody in the club, but his phone go off and save everybody's life? In the club, like, hell no, they was trying my shoe, but I'll fight everybody in this beat for real, cuz. Hello? Yeah, I'm about to shoot everybody in this beat, cuz. Nah, I'm sorry, they tried my goddamn jail. Post search announcement too, fellas. If you got complicated as your Facebook status, you are gay. No dude put no goddamn complicated. Grown ass man, you put no or yes, yeah, shit. Ladies, y'all agree? What ladies that mention? Ladies, y'all agree? Now if a girl got this complicated, that means she got a crazy dude that don't take no for an answer. You might want to leave that bitch alone. Oh my goodness. And ladies, y'all was tripping college. Y'all would talk shit about y'all homegirl as she walking towards y'all. Look at Tamika, her hair is some bullshit. Hey, girl. This bitch look like Royce. What the hell? Hey, what's up? Royce be having on some bullshit, bud. You get out here with that Target dress on? Time to be on that bitch drunk. So the time to get a Michelob, that bitch is gone. One beer. Hey, it's a wrap on the night. Anybody done did it already? Y'all only been here a week. Somebody done boned already. Y'all tell them they done boned already. Yeah, somebody done been cut up already. Don't feel bad, ladies. We want to, that's what, ladies, y'all girls in college are so mad that y'all be wanting to do it more than guys want to do it, right, ladies? So y'all do it when they do it and don't talk to him no goddamn more. Some of y'all dudes be trying to act like y'all players, and them girls be the one that's the players. Girls is the players. Ladies, y'all ever try to give a dude some, and he get too attached, it's gonna be like a one-night stand. You want him to leave, you want him to hit it and leave. You come back in the room, this nigga butt naked with a guitar, talking about, I see you had a lot of crush. Yes. Had a lot of. Nigga, where you get a guitar from? Bring nothing to my room. God, my roommate is asleep, stupid. Jeez, I hate you a lot. Oh my goodness. I remember when I was dating, I've got to tell y'all too, I just celebrated my 6-year wedding anniversary. Been married 6 years, I've got to tell y'all. Yes! Don't clap too hard, I don't like her ass no more. She don't even know where I'm at right now. She think I'm taking out the trash right now. I just got on 20 and left that bitch. I remember my wife in college, fellas, like, some of y'all ladies gonna change in college. Has anybody ever dated a crazy chick before, fellas? You ever messed with the crazy chick before? Right? You don't find out she crazy. You don't know she crazy, because the crazy chicks are usually really nice at first, right, fellas? You don't find out she crazy until the first night y'all spend the night in the same room. Not necessarily sexual. Y'all just chilling, watching a movie, fall asleep, innocent. You roll over at like 4 a.m, she look at you right in your face. Like, babe, what's wrong? Nothing, just watching your ass sleep. You think about that bitch, ain't you? I'm like, damn, man, I just met you yesterday. What are you talking about? And it's messed up, because ladies, we can't be honest with y'all. Fellas, most of the time, if we talk to a girl for over 7 minutes, we want to do it with y'all, right, fellas? If we want to bone, most of the time, because we come up there with that small talk and all that bullshit, most of the time, you really just want to walk up to her and just say, just, as soon as you walk up to it, this all you. This what you think? Hey, how you doing? My name. Don't you wish you could just say that and she just get naked right outside? You're like, hell yeah. I ain't got no rubber, but she look clean. That's how fellas we play Russian roulette with our penis, don't we, fellas? As soon as you hear that bitch cough, you like, I'ma die. Yeah, that bitch get running up. This bitch got full blown AIDS. Don't stop though. I'm all gonna do. That's a deal breaker right there, fellas. Right? You been talking to her ass all night, giving her a drink. That bitch go like this. Oh! I hate you. God, I don't want to do this anymore. And some of y'all looking at me in awe, like, I didn't know they make polo shirts that big. Kiss my ass, whatever. They got them on the website, RalphLauren.com. Kiss my ass, I can be cute. Y'all got me on these french fry lights in this bitch, too. I feel like the last hot dog in Quick Trip just turned on me. Ain't nobody gonna buy me, huh? Just me. And one taquito left. I should have been going on the floor right now and killed my goddamn self. And ladies in college, it's weird because all the girls in college, y'all want a bad boy gangster type. Like, ladies, what ladies don't like the bad boy type of guy? Make sure you know you like the thug type of dude. You can be honest. Every school I do, like, seven girls, like, ooh, punch me in the throat. That is so sexy. Ain't nothing like a first date in the emergency room, bitch. You get a bracelet and everything, scrapbook. Say that before. Anything happy in her life, she put in her mental scrapbook. A bitch got a negative pregnancy test, scrapbook, wet. Y'all gonna put that shit on Twitter tonight, pound scrapbook, wet, W-H-E-T, wet. Make sure y'all tag me on the at Ronnie Jordan. Y'all give me a shout out right now. I don't care. Oh, goodness. I like the late laughs. You got Tourette's and shit. You saying shit that don't match. Peanut butter and jelly tastes good on toasted bread. What? I got nephews, man. Anybody was sick? Anybody babysitting this summer? Anybody tired of babysitting? Y'all sick of babysitting? Oh! I ain't got no kids. I be having to babysit. Look, kids are mean as hell now. Have y'all noticed how mean they are? They say whatever they want to your ass and want you to be nice to them. My nephew, one of them 9, one of them 8 years old, they asking me dumb shit on the way to Walmart. We walking in Target, I'm going to buy them Nintendo DS games. It's 112 degrees outside. My nephew just staring at me, talking about, Uncle Ronnie, why are you sweating? Uncle Ronnie, you are sweating so much, it is coming down all over your body. I said, it's 100 degrees outside, just as hot. We get in Target, walk around for like 5 minutes, he just look at me, Uncle Ronnie, you are still sweating. You are sweating all over your body, it's on your shirt, and on your stomach. Why are you still sweating? I said, I'm fat just the shit. That ain't your real dad at your house. I don't want to babysit. You treat them like adults, man. And it's weird, because I try to take them to do stuff in the summertime, go swimming. I go to the ghetto-ass park to go swimming. Anybody go to the ghetto pool, got too much chlorine and shit? You gotta wear a coat in the pool, goddamn, and shit burns so bad. I go to take a shower after we go swimming. I got my own little man cave in my crib. It's the bathroom in there. They in there playing video games. He must have forgotten I was in taking the shower. I get out the shower naked by the drive. He busts in the bathroom, and the look of confusion on this 8-year-old's face looking at my big ass body was the funniest shit in the world. I got out, he looking at me like this. Uncle Ronnie got everything. Look at how I got that bathroom. Oh, shit. Like, I love your laugh, I swear to God. Summertime cookout season, Spades players in the house, where the Spades players at? It's a black school, I know y'all been playing Spades all goddamn week. There's some niggas that don't even go to school here, being in the students and playing Spades and shit. Y'all got that, them locals be playing Spades. Get your local ass out of here. You ain't got no book bag. It's horrible. I ain't no Spades with some live or die shit with black people. Did y'all know this shit? You will fight your family over a Spades game. This is a true story. My daddy got one sister. He ain't talked to her since 97 because she reneged. My mama tried to invite her to Thanksgiving and shit. This nigga went off. She said, you know Wanda coming. Fuck Wanda. The bitch cutting clubs. You are petty as hell. You can't cut a club, goddamn come back play a club. Daddy, you didn't let it go. So now we can't play Spades in my house. My mama outlawed Spades at the house Thanksgiving. Now we gotta play Uno. I didn't know ghetto people could take Uno to the next level. Did y'all know this shit? You would fight over a goddamn Uno game now. Cause every time, like in the summertime, you always got like a cousin from out of town or uncle. Everybody don't play Uno the same. Did y'all know this shit? Everybody play different. Jersey got that one uncle sitting over there with 40 Uno cards in his hand. He waiting on one car, he drop them all at the same time. The nigga talking about Skip, he reverse back to me, drop four Uno game out. He's like, we play train where I'm from. He's like, nigga, you better call that shit. Another thing I want to talk about. In Atlanta, we got something going on. I don't know, did y'all know Atlanta is number one in gay population in the world? Did y'all know that? Atlanta is the gayest place on earth. It's funny because yo, Atlanta's the gayest place. If you look at Atlanta from outer space, it's techno music playing like glitter and fist pumping and glitter and gummy bears and Linux bombs and everything. So, and I know it's gonna trickle down to colleges, but you know, I just hate it when the news is on the down low. Don't you hate that shit, ladies? Oh, that's the worst, man. If you gay, be gay, that's fine. I just hate it when, because we got dudes in Atlanta that are like super gay. Like, y'all know it's the difference between regular gay and super gay, right? You know, regular gay people cool, you don't even care that they gay, they normal, they pay taxes. Nice people, super gay people are usually extra rude, extra flamboyant. They cuss people out for no goddamn reason. And you know what? You run into a super gay dude by mistake, fellas, in Atlanta. I don't care how masculine you think you are, you will run into a super gay dude by mistake. Because he look normal, at first you ask him a normal guy question, and he turns super gay right before your eyes. I'm in the mall asking dude, I would run laps and said, excuse me, bro, you know what time it is? It was like, he looked like a normal dude, it looked like a very candy sprinkle gay dust on his head. I was like, what, you know what time it is? He just went out, it's time for your stupid ass to get a watch. I was like, what you spray me with? He was like, Febreze, because you got a stankin' ass attitude. He just walked out. He disappeared, what the hell? I'm in the mall confused as hell, like, did I just get sprayed in the face with some air freshener by a gay dude? Am I gonna be gay now? This is how it spreads. What they put glitter and Febreze? What the hell is this shit? That's why I hate flying, but every time I fly, I always get a flight attendant that's super gay, fellas. I always get a flight attendant that's the wrong body style to be gay or flight attendant. This dude 6'8", black as hell with a hairdo like Fantasia. He got crimps over one eye, purple contacts in, and a name tag that says Peaches. He's standing at the front of the plane, directing everybody to their seats as rude as possible. First of all, he's standing there, he doing the super gay guy bounce. You ever seen a super gay guy bounce? They can't stand in place for long, they just bounce in place. You seen them. You walk up on like regular guy, be like, dude, I'm going to the mall, you just talk. Super gay guy's like, girl, I'm going to the mall, right? Like, what are you bouncing for? Are you acting like a beauty? What the hell is that? So he had to run the plane, directing everybody to their seats as rude as possible. He's talking about, take your ass to the back. Boop, boop, thank you, bye-bye, yes. Yes, that's a T-Mobile bitch. I put you on pause. Boop, boop, yes. All the other flight attendants hate him, but they can't do nothing about it because he's the lead flight attendant. It's a full flight. Everybody ready to take off? We cannot take off until Peaches reads the safety instructions. He walks in the front of the plane singing Beyonce loud as hell. He walks in front of the plane just, if I was a boy. I'm like, you are a boy. A tall black ass boy. God, I hate you a lot. He start reading the safety instructions, but he reading them in super gay. He go to the plane with the intercom with attitude, he just...
Welcome to Airstream Airways, I'm your flight attendant, Peaches. I will be assisting you in the front cabinet. Follow along in your brochure as I read out loud the safety instructions. First, we'll go over how to buckle up your seatbelt.
First, you take the loose end of the buckle, you put it through the flat end of the belt, you'll be like, you little slut ass, see, man, where you were last weekend? Oh, I'm sorry, hon, I forgot what I was saying. Everybody playing looking at the brochure, what the hell is he talking about? Jesus! I'm gonna send a freaking email, it's ridiculous! And he keep reading the safety instructions, but he still read them in super gay. He's talking about, in case we lose cabinet pressure, it's gonna be a little yellow masses that come down. You put your masses on first and then help anybody else out with their masses. I'm praying to God we don't lose cap press because I'm thinking, and the whole time I'm laughing like a mother. I'm thinking he heard me laugh too. I'm thinking if my oxygen mask does have to drop, he gonna play a trick on me. My mask gonna drop, it's gonna be a dick in my mask. Just. I seem to have a penis in my breathing apparatus. Is the penis blocked there? Is the air indeed traveling through the penis? Now you think I'm front of me coming to my seat to my 14-8, you so crazy. I like little fat boys too. Get away from you, Peaches. Trying to go to sleep, shit. That's what's the first thing you do when you get on a flight? You try to go straight to sleep, right? You ever go, because when you get on a plane, you try to stay up for 2 days if you got a flight, right? You pass out as soon as you hit the seatbelt. Click, ah! sleep harder than you ever slept before. But have you ever slept so hard that somebody wake you up too fast, you don't know where the hell you at? That happened to me. I had people wake me up out of a dead sleep. I thought I was having a nightmare. I'm in a knockdown. All I hear is, excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir, would you like some penis? I said, would you like some peanuts, some salted peanuts? I was like, oh, you got enunciate, bro. You almost got punched in the ear, Jesus. No, thank you. I can't take nuts from a dude named Peaches. I am so sorry. Like I was saying, I was tired. I'm glad I didn't get married because I always ended up dating. Before I went to school, when I was in college, I used to always end up dating females with kids. I have no problem dating females because I just hate dumbass kids. Does anybody hate to see a stupid ass child? Let me piss you off. Especially if they black. Don't hurt your soul to see a dumb black child. I'm talking about dumb as hell. Like, you know they know every song on the radio but can't spell shit. Don't that piss you off? Because you want to speak to little cute kids, right? You see them, they're 5, 6 years old. You see them in the grocery store. And you want to talk to them and they disappoint you as soon as they open their mouth. Soon as you open, you're like, hey, little man, how you doing? What's your name? He's talking about Tony Montana. Tony, you an ignorant little bastard, huh? I should have punched you in the throat right now. I was talking to this one girl. I thought she was the one until her little, I met a little boy. We broke up. Soon as her little boy, I met a little boy. I went over her house. Her little boy messed with me. As soon as I knock on the door, he just, Mama, that fat man acting dumb. That fat man acting dumb. That fat man is acting dumb. Come on in, fat man. I go to ask him a question, he come in, I'm like, wait, Mom, I don't have no cookies for you, no candies for you, no chickens for you, fat man. Hey, fat man, I bet you eat whole chicken like this. Oh! And the whole chicken be alive inside your big stomach. Because they have room to live in a formal community. I go to Young, and I walk up some steps, he panic. I was like, hey, come on, please leave me, fat man, please don't eat me. I got pissed off. I was like, you said one more thing to me, I'm gonna knock your little ass. He told me, you ain't gonna do shit, Batman. Cause you a MWT. A MWT. I'm like, what the hell is an MWT, little punk? You a man with titties. Man with titties. Man with titties. That Batman got two big old titties. I'm in a drawback and they probably about to knock a little bit out. He's going, please leave me, man, please don't hit me. Cause you'll catch the breast cancer. You'll catch breast cancer. That man will catch the breast cancer. I break up his mom. Now he really pissed off. I break up his mom. He called my house, leave him harassing messages. He called my house, about where he get them titties from? He get it from his mom. So I'm gonna get breast cancer. I was in the house the same night in the shower, get myself a breast exam. Like, what the hell? For the lump, I think I need a mammogram, damn it. We got any Greeks in the house? Where the Greeks at? I ain't even seen nobody. Y'all got Greeks here? You got Deltas? Is it AKs? Is it AKs? What is that? Was that Sigmas? Huh? Sigmas, we got alphas in here, alphas in here. Y'all should have sat together, though. That would have worked out a little better. What the cubes at? The cubes in house? Omegas? They kicked off the yard, ain't they? Every school I go to, they kicked off the goddamn yard. They can walk around butt naked with some gold boots on. Put your dick up, cute dog. Shit. You all would draw down on anybody. Your parents, day, grandmama, what's up? Put your dick up. That's my grandmama. Kappas in the house. What the Kappas in? Kappas. Hey, y'all deep cry. Y'all sound kind of soft though, in there. Y'all sound. What are you talking about? Change clothes when they fight you, goddamn. Wait, say something. I'm gonna come back when I change clothes, bitch. mean, that stroll, it'll be 112 degrees. They got a three-piece suit on. They don't even sweat, do they?
Like that, y'all cool as hell to me.
Sigmas, I got y'all. Anybody else? Did I miss anybody? Iotas or? Why both of y'all ain't say the same shit? Before I got to him, we gonna watch, we gonna say something new, watch. I'm in a fraternity, that's all fat news. We be like, I hop! Oh, shit! Funny guy, I'm gonna get this chick, what up? There she go, I love that laugh. After the show, I got my t-shirts for sale. If y'all want to get one, I'm about to do my last joke. Matter of fact, I got another. Y'all heard that Racks on Racks song before? Y'all familiar with Racks on Racks, right? If y'all want me to do it, I got my own parody. I did my own video to it. It's called Snacks on Snacks. Y'all want me to do it? Yeah. All right, you got to play that number five, DJ. Y'all gonna clap with me? Come on, y'all. Jackson State, what's up?
What you got? Snacks on snacks. Hey, she got snacks on snacks.
Turn out. Got a potty green cooking so strong. Want a pizza when I'm on the phone. Need milk application wrong. Real fat ones ain't no clone. We the top where we belong. We drink three Kool-Aid Patrol. So we don't thought no from him. Right as hell, don't give a damn. Got snacks on snacks. Snacks on snacks. Snacks on snacks. Get it, people hate, fall back. Got a walk off in my garage. Got a condo full of Mars. Just right the candy bars. Got a car can't fit this part. No key who moves out far. I like soft bread, don't like hard. I got a Subway Platinum card. I beat a hot dog in a bar. DVD after the show. I got my DVD for $5, and I got my t-shirts. I got one more joke. Don't leave. I got a good joke for y'all at the end, but I got my t-shirts. I got two shirts. My Ronnie Jordan shirt sold out at my last show, so I only got them in big size, but I got them on my website, ronniejordan.net. If y'all, are y'all familiar with the Michael Jordan Jumpman symbol? You ever see that in the flight sign? I got my own, except it's my body. It's the Ronnie Jordan Jumpman. I only got big sizes left. Y'all want to see it? The shirt is $10. Oh, this ain't the one. But I only got big sizes left. I got them on my website, though. Y'all can get them on my website. This is it right here. I sell out at all my colleges all over the country. And I got another shirt. This is a shirt I made up like last year because I say it a lot. I say, Jesus, I hate you a lot. And this shirt says, Jesus, I hate you a lot. You can wear it if you're messing with somebody you really don't like. Here it is right here. That's the I hate you a lot shirt right there. I got two, I'm about to get up out of here. Y'all had a good time so far at Jackson State? Y'all get up for Mr. Quinn for putting this show together. Y'all get up for Mr. Quinn. I do my last joke, get up out of here. I forgot to tell y'all, over the summer, I lost 30 pounds. Y'all give it up for me, I lost 30 pounds. I'm trying, you know, we gotta start somewhere, right? I told my daddy, I was like, Dad, I lost 30 pounds. He was like, look behind you, you're fine. I was like, I hate you a lot. Well, I got a couple tricks to make it look, it wasn't fast enough though. I want to be slim in like an hour and I heard it don't work like that. So I got a couple tricks that I stole from big people to make it look like you lose weight quicker than you really are. Oh, before I do that, I got one more new joke. Y'all want to see my new shit? Y'all, I got a new joke I want to show y'all. Somebody on Twitter said I look like a fat LeBron James. I just need y'all to confirm yes or no. Just tell me, hold on. Appreciate y'all being patient. I'm trying my new stuff out. You know, you gotta do your new material. But I'm trying to lose weight, but I got a couple tricks to make it look like you lose weight quicker than you really are. One of my tricks I stole from females, because I think females are the smartest people on the planet. Yes. Y'all got the best tricks in the world. If you big, all you gotta do if you big is wear your clothes about two or three sizes too big and wait on people to give you compliments. That shit works. My friends are like, Ryan, you look like you're losing weight. I'm like, yeah, you know, I'm just drinking water. know the Lord is working, but he's not finished. But my number one trick I stole from females, all you gotta do if you big is hang out with people way fatter than you and you look slim as hell in the group. My fat friends get pissed off when I go on a diet. They come to my house talking shit. Talking about you done lost 2 pounds, old sis ass boy. You out of circle, old fuck ass boy. Cause you so smart, I'm just leave it right here for your ass. This is honey, y'all. I'm gonna let y'all know this is my kryptonite. I enjoy nothing more than a glazed pastry. Yeah, matter of fact, this is a spirit. It needs to be rebuked in Jesus' name. And if you're my friend, you don't do no stuff like that to me. It was hard as hell. I was in the room just like this. Thank you so much. Hit me on Twitter @RonnieJordan. Thank you so much.